You had better come out of there alive.
I plan to. Books. No wisdom. Just you, fratello mio. Requiescat in pace, Altair. You have seen to my books?
Yes. Some we sent with the Polos. The rest will go with me to Alexandria.
Good. Very good.
Father, I do not understand. Why did you build a library if you did not intend to keep your books?
You should go. When the Mongols return, Masyaf must be empty.
I see. This is not a library at all. It is a vault.
It must stay hidden, Darim. Far from eager hands, at least until it has passed on the secret it contains.
What secret?
Go, son. Go be with your family. And live well.
All that is good in me began with you, father.
Much wisdom is much grief, and he that increaseth knowledge increaseth sorrow.
What does it tell you? What do you see?
Strange visions and messages of ones who came before, of their rise and their fall.
But what happens to us, Altair? To our family, what does the apple say?
Who were the ones who came before? What brought them here? How long ago?
Get rid of that thing!
This is my duty, Maria. Maria? If you are asked, say I sent the apple away. Tell them I sent it to Cyprus, or Sipango, or that I dropped it into the sea. Tell them anything to keep men away from this place. This apple must not be found. Not until the time is right.
Another artifact. No. You will stay here. I have seen enough for one life. Desmond?
He's talking to me?
I heard your name once before, Desmond. A long time ago. And now it lingers in my mind, like an image from an old dream. I do not know where you are, or by what means you can hear me. But I know you are listening. I have lived my life as best I could, not knowing its purpose, but drawn forward like a moth to a distant moon. And here at last, I discover a strange truth. That I am only a conduit for a message that eludes my understanding. Who are we who have been so blessed to share our stories like this? Speak across centuries. Maybe you will answer all the questions I have asked. Maybe you will be the one to make all this suffering worth something in the end. Now, listen.
Do you hear me, Cypher? Can you see me? Strange place, this nexus of time. I am not used to the calculations. That has always been Minerva's domain. I see you still have many questions. Who were we? What became of us? What do we desire of you? You will have your answers. Only listen, and I will tell you how. Both before the end and after, we sought to save the world. We built vaults within which to work, each dedicated to a different method of salvation. They were placed underground to avoid the war which raged above, and also as a precaution should we fail in our efforts. Each vault's knowledge was transmitted to a single place. It was our duty, mine, Minerva's, and Juno's, to sort and sample all that was collected. We chose those solutions which held the most promise and devoted ourselves to testing their merits. Six we tried in succession, each more encouraging than the last, but none worked. And then the world ended.
Thank you.
The earth shook for days. The fires burned for weeks. And when the ash had settled, less than 10,000 of your kind still lived, and far fewer of ours. But we carried on, together, to rebuild, to renew. Listen, you must go there, to the place where we labored, labored and lost. Take my words, pass them from your head into your hands. That is how you will open the way. But be warned, much still remains in flux, and I do not know how things will end, either in my time or yours.
Wait, look, his vitals are stabilizing. Something's happening. He's moving.
Desmond. Can you hear me? Son?
I know what we need to do.